Nazem, boy, you were good today. That game-winning goal was something. Can you take me through what you saw in front of the net there on that goal?
Not here.
He's not here, but I'm sure he's pretty happy.
Sorry? Okay. I thought they said he was going to be here.
And that's going to do it for regulation time. Well, in this first playoff game of 2020, we go to extra time. That's going to do it for the first overtime. That's going to do it for the second overtime. 100 minutes of hockey so far in game number one. Sends it across. Fed in front, and it's sent wide by McDonough. As he had Cirelli out in front of the net, and time runs out in the third overtime.
McDonough's kicking himself there.
Welcome to game three, ladies and gentlemen. Played exactly. Six periods already, so this is basically game three.
Does so. Edmund shoots. 6A by Corposato. That'll do it. Horn sounds, ending our seventh period of hockey tonight. Overtime number five. That hit Gavrikov. They score! It's fired by Braden Point. The shot hit Gavrikov, came back to Point, and he fires it in for the game-winning goal in overtime number five, and the Lightning capture game one of the series.
Edmonton for a high hit to the head on Tyler Ennis of the Oilers. And behind the net, Strome. Duncan Keith out high. Nylander throws it towards the net. Julep moves it in the middle. Nylander. Now Strome, a wrist shot. That caught some iron.
Robin Leonard fell awkward. I think there's something wrong with his skate. Can't stand up on that left side.
Taves with it. Keith straight away with a wrist shot. Blocked in front. And hit Kubelik.
I think Leonard lost his steal again.
He did. You can see it to his left as play continues. You can hear the referee, I think, responding to Leonard saying, I don't have any blade on my left skate.
You can hear the Chicago player, he's got no blade, he's got no blade.
Well, the Golden Knights will try to get a whistle here. Now they get one. Robin Leonard, it's the second time in this period he's been in this boat.
It's not a fun feeling.
There's a turnover. Konechny comes in with Hayes. They're two on one. The centering pass. Kevin Hayes in front. Lawton drilled a shot. I thought he had 4x6 to shoot at. Just got his stick on that and tipped it.
And he had Suzuki down on his knees in front. That was a dangerous play for Suzuki. There goes the steal of Gallagher. So he's on one foot trying to get to the bench. And he falls. Finally gets off. And they live to fight another day.
It was a pass back stolen. And here's Shen. He's in the clear. Hey, score!
Yes!
Some midnight magic from Shen!
Yes!
Shen!
Yes!
Shen!
Yes!
Shen!
Do you believe in miracles? Yes!
Shen!
Here's McCarr. Shoots! Knocked down in front, backhanded! Score! It's a power play goal! Nazem Kadri with a huge power play goal. Puts the Avs on top, and now Big Val will rumble in after the draw. Kicks it up to the point. Long shot there. Save, rebound! Tipped free! Score! J.T. Compher!
Two Colorado goals in the span of 10 seconds, Tyson.
Now that stings.
It just doesn't seem like...
Well, you can imagine up for the app.
Oh, no! Landeskog and McKinnon run into each other. You see Ranton and Landeskog and McKinnon
But you're not expecting to get run into it. You don't prepare yourself.
Here's Theodore with a long wrist shot. Save Crawford. Rebound Stastny poking at it. But Crawford has it. 4:45 to go in the first. Close-up look at Jonathan Marchessault in the Chicago net.
Tyler Mott and David Perron really battling it there. Schwartz took the hit. Perron came in. He was going for a change as well. Perron doesn't retaliate. That's big. Mott's lucky he didn't get caught with a roughing. He swatted him in the noggin a couple of times. And then the goalie, Thatcher Demko, grabbed Perron's stick and wouldn't give it up.
No, the battle. Coming off the ice.
I missed me between the benches.
I bet you do. Still kept it in. It's loose. Bounces to Lindholm. And the stick of Hudobin went flying after Lindholm came free. And Hudobin got enough to deflect it out of play.
Right above the blocker, had it ripped, had it labeled, and the skinny part of Hudobin's stick makes the save.
Victor Hedman wants to make a line change, tries to jump into the Columbus bench. Yeah, you can't do that.
Illegal change. It's not too many men, it's a legal change. You can't jump in their bench. Too many. You can't jump in the other team's bench on a change. Tampa penalty, bench minor, too many men on the ice. Well, I could call it too many men or illegal substitution. It doesn't matter. Too many men. Doesn't matter.
Brought right back in and all alone and a goal, and it's 3-0. And Darcy Kuemper frustrated, and guess who? Nazem Kadri.
He is not happy.
Nor should he be.
No. The Flippers are Pelican Pulak.
Barzell's out of the box. Kuznetsov drives and scores. Evgeny Kuznetsov cuts right across the crease.
Woo! Ronaldo.
The Canadians, they're winning all those loose puck battles. Armia centering, scores! Off a skate and in, and the fourth line joins the fun. It's 4-0 Montreal.
Armia throws it, goes off the skate of his defenseman, Goss to spare.
Across ice, moving up on it, Myers for a shot, they score! It got through Price!
A little squibber that was going wide, Carey Price deflected that into his own net off the inside of his paddle. You'll take it.
Farabee working in the slot, one time, a score! Jake Voracek from Claude Giroux, a power play goal, and it's tied 1-1.
Does this hit Sherrod in front? Yeah, look at the reaction of Price right off the stick. It goes off the shaft of Ben Sherrod and up and over the glove.
Goes across the ice. Voracek changes the angle. Score! Tipped in by Sean Couturier.
I think this is another one off of Ben Sherrod.
You think it's off a Canadian?
You watch body language, and this one goes, yep, right off Sherrod. Tough place. Watch the feet of Sherrod. He tries to either get a block or get out of the way.
Around behind the net, they try to center it in front. Hey, centers! They score! And deflect it in!
And I think this one goes off of Lekkonen as well. This is Hayes, who just shows great patience, and this one goes off the stick of Lekkonen coming back and between the five hole of Carey Price. So there's yet another one.
The Flames will carry in Backlund shorthanded, trying to turn off Perry, and the puck is in the net behind Hudobin. It bounced up, it just rolled over the Stars netminder.
Man, that thing had to roll up its sleeves and crawl over the left pad. You're right, another excruciating shorthanded tally against.
Come back to TJ Brody. Here's Brody gonna tee it up and score! A rocket for Brody! Traffic in front, Hudobin without his mask, but it's 2-0 Flames.
Trying to shake it off, and it gets up high to Bennett. His shot out to challenge, making the save. Hudobin, and they banked it in off of him. Gaudreau from the corner.
Scrambly, Wambly, man, this has been a full ambush from the Flames as Hudobin was trying to scramble back in. A 2-0 lead and an awful start for the Stars here.
Sagan counterattacks 3-on-3. He's got a trailer, and Klingberg keeps it in front. And Ben put himself into the net. He's saying he put the puck there first.
They say if you're thirsty for goals, head to the water bottle that sits atop the opposing netminder's net. And as he rocked the rack, he makes this a 1-0 hockey game. Quite a goal. That was a violent opening tally.
Back out to Kukin. Good play by McDonough. Higher there. They score from the boards. It's fired by Bjorkstrand from the boards at a sharp angle.
This is an amazing shot. He's just going to whirl around and shoot it from the boards right by the left ear of Vasilevsky.
Parayko with 90 seconds to go, gives it to number 90. And now back in their own zone, Scandella got crossed up. Pettersson's in. Elias Pettersson scores! And they return fire and have tied it.
This is just miscommunication here. Scandella and Parayko, they both went at the puck. It's an easy play to get this one out.
Hopped over his stick behind the net. He's going to score! Miro Heiskanen found the short side on Cam Talbot, and it's a two-goal Dallas lead.
Just an opportunity to get a puck to the net, and you'll see him. He doesn't even really look. Not one time did he look up to see where the net was. He knows exactly where it is, and that knuckle puck finds its way in on that short side. Not a goal you want to give up.
Morgan Geekie refines the handle. He'll dump it in.
I got to wonder why the... Oh, boy.
Look out. They score. The Canes jump on it. A loose play for Nino Niederreiter.
A goaltender's nightmare, Brian.
Yep, just trying to do too much. And he had his head down. He didn't see Niederreiter there. The play was to just give it to McAvoy in the corner. And now the Hurricanes have some life.
Coleman, back of the point. McDonough shooting. It's in the goal mouth. Court trying to jam it home. Corposato drove across. They score! It's rolled in the net.
The goaltender Corposalo can't find it for a second. Oh my goodness, and it came free. You couldn't see that from our vantage point here. Corposalo actually kicks it in on his own.
The Hawks through center. Highmore chips it to himself. Scores from below the goal line in the left wing corner. Somehow Matthew Highmore beat Robin Leonard. And a
It's 2-0 Hawks.
No one saw this, and Robin Leonard, certainly one he would like back. That is a tough goal as the Blackhawks now up 2-0.
Backstrom out high. Kuznetsov will let it go. Save made. Rebound is there and cleared down the ice. Skipping, rolling towards an empty net. They score! It goes in!
That's luck. That's not skill. That's just luck. And that's Nick Leddy. And you know what? He deserves the goal, doesn't he, Brendan? I mean, he has been really good. Washington Capitals, on that chase going back, the Capitals are going, oh my goodness, that's going in. I got to really get on my horse. Too late.
Now back to Krejci. Krejci to Pasternak. Pasternak fires one that Mrazek has the body over the net. And from a sharp angle, they score! Patrice Bergeron catches Peter Mrazek off of his skate from behind the net. And the Bruins take a 2-1 lead with 3.5 seconds to go in the second period.
Ryan O'Reilly's got the puck. Alex Petrangelo breaks his stick. Maybe a chance for Mott here. Tyler Mott attacking. Gets past Petrangelo and scores! Short-handed beauty for Tyler Mott.
Great recognition that the stick was broken for Petrangelo. What a move through him. Challenge the man that doesn't have the stick. That's exactly what he does. Gets his feet moving early, looks up, makes this great inside move, one-handed, and bang, tucks it home for a 1-0 lead, shorthanded.
And the Canucks break the ice in game five.
Passes down low, Kucherov shooting. That's blocked, point in time. They score! Cirelli out in front. I believe it deflected off Cirelli, and the Lightning have tied this game up.
And that one was like a curling rock, barely going over the line. Savard is watching in slow motion in his mind while he can't get to it either because he's busy doing his thing, and all of a sudden it's tied back up.
Here's McCarr.
All right, today. Set it off a line
and score!
That's how you gotta solve Kemper. You gotta bang it off somebody down low.
Now that's unbelievable.
Three guys.
It hit three different players. One, Arizona. Two, Arizona. And then I don't know if it hit Landeskog's skate or not.
Looked like maybe the right ankle.
But still in the Bruins end for right now. They finally pop it out into the Kane zone. Jake DeBrusk comes in. Reimer comes out to play it. And DeBrusk scores! As James Reimer tried to play the rolling puck and DeBrusk got a stick to it.
As a goaltender, if you're gonna go, you have to be sure. And Reimer, I think, was just a tad indecisive. High risk, low reward.
Around it goes, Jay Beagle off the bench trying to knock it down. Mott took a whack at it, Delarose stepped on it. Beagle scores! Jay Beagle has the icebreaker!
A mishap here, stepping on the puck. Looks like it's controlled. As this puck comes along the wall, and you're gonna see Delarose fall on that puck. He can't kick it out, and Jay Beagle pounces on it.
Wines, that's right on. Rask has to make the save. Now Svechnikov tries the lacrosse move, but can't get to it. Oh, he was thinking about it and couldn't get to it. The Bruins were there to defend it.
We sat down with Andre and asked him, would you try the lacrosse goal with the game on the line? And you knew he would. And Boston was prepared.
Able to get a pad on it and then pounce on it with a little snow shower of the mask to boot.
A little bit of a snow shower, looks like, from his own player at the end. Comb it out of his beard and mustache.
Across for O'Reilly to play the final shift for St. Louis. Ryan O'Reilly puts it in front and scores! Found a little room short side, and Ryan O'Reilly has his fingerprints on game five.
I don't know if that goes off the tip of the stick of Ben, but that's a little too much time and space for the top player of the St. Louis Blues, and he makes the Canucks pay with another goal. They're on the attack, and it's in the back of your net.
Pettersson on the ice. That hit the official open net. Markstrom! Oh, did you see that? Off the linesman, an open net as Markstrom was out to play it and somehow got back in time to save the day.
That was unbelievable, and that wasn't a typical save. He did everything that he could just to get a piece of that puck. And what a job by him to get back into the net and make this save. Just a shot by Petrangelo to put it into the zone. It goes right out to Delarose. Tyler Seguin will start at center of the top line with Ben and Radulov. And this is a little gamesmanship before, after the warm-up this game got started. Tyler Seguin wanted to be the last one off. David Rittich says, wait a second, comes back and plays peekaboo a bit to say, okay, you know what, you can have it this time. But just goes to show you where the head of Tyler Seguin is coming into this game number two, very much ready to get going. Hits the right pad of Hudobin, and again, this one, the blast is fought off with the glove hand side. And this is the reaction of Matthew Tkachuk as he's been watching this power play, and I'm sure he wants nothing more than to try and get in there and help out his teammates.
Ibarrenta's in. Talbot puts up a rebound, and they score! Dennis Gurianov has his fourth of the game.
And that's the reaction of Matthew Tkachuk up in the suite.
Did he clip
Brody with his stick right in front of the net, and that's why he was favoring his grill. TJ Brody had his chiclets rearranged, teeth on the ice.
Now that he's out of position, the Canes come back 3-on-1. Niederreiter toe drags across, and oh, somehow the Canes can't connect the dots and could not finish. And Boston survives a scare there by the Canes.
This is how it's supposed to look. What a look from Niederreiter, and he just misses it. Just misses it. Otherwise, it's 3-0 Carolina.
35 on the power play with Green in the box. Kuznetsov looking back door, and Ovechkin hit the outside of the net as the pass slowed up on its way. This was a glorious opportunity, and he doesn't miss too many of those.
No, he doesn't. He just handcuffs him just a hair and had an empty net. McAvoy flattens it, pivots, cross-ice pass. Jake DeBrusk misses an open goal off Wagner's sweet feed.
Jake DeBrusk couldn't pull it through.
So a big 5-on-3 for the Philadelphia Flyers, but some big plays around the net. A good one there for Carey Price, and it's the stick's fault the Flyers are behind.
Sent back up the boards once more, walked on by Mata. Across, oh, and a shot off the iron by Kane.
Watch the reaction, got the wide open net to see Marc-Andre's glove banging the post.
There have been goaltenders in the past who've actually kissed the posts.
With Nico Bay-Cubel now,
Hakaniemi with a shot right off the goal post on the stick side of Carter Hart. Oh, a sizzler there now. Gulak, his shot hits the other goal post and Kareem's on a play.
So Carter Hart has some thinking to do for his goal posts as Canadians are able to pick the corners but not able to tickle the twine.
Oh, yeah, they've shattered the plexiglass. The silica-based environmental interface is severely damaged. Now they have to change some glass. I wonder if they're just going to push this to the third period.
Yeah.
You wouldn't want that if you were Calgary, I don't think, on
fresh ice.
Yes.
But, yeah, if this is going to be a 15, 20-minute...
Yeah, Rick Bowles. Yes.
I'll take
yes.
it.
I like that.
Not exactly the same reaction on the Flames bench. All right. So I guess we will hand off to the second intermission report.
He's got to get back. Here comes Suzuki. Durant goes to the net. There's a shot. He scores. Nick Suzuki right through Hart.
And he's gone.
Alain Vigneault has seen enough. I mean, you can just see it coming. Isn't this the craziest game?
Hart's hanging around right now.
Yeah.
So there's a challenge here. And so Elliott's going to stay where he is for the moment.
After reviewing the play, it's determined the play was offside. Therefore, we have no goal.
The emotions for Hart. You let that one in. He saw that Elliott was getting ready. And then all of a sudden, the video coach is calling in to Alain Vigneault saying, whoa, 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 whoa. This one's not in.
Wow.